Section 14 of the Emerald Storybook. This is a LibriVox recording. All LibriVox recordings are in the public domain. For more information or to volunteer, please visit LibriVox.org. Read by Telly Tiger. The Emerald Storybook, The Little Acorn. It was a little acorn that hung on the bough of a tree. It had a tender green cup and a beautifully carved saucer to hold it. The mother oak fed it with a sweet sap every day. The birds sang good night songs above it, and the wind rocked it gently to and fro. The oak leaves made a soft green shade above it, so the sun could not shine too warm on its green cover, and it was as happy as an acorn could be. There were many other acorns on the tree, and I am sure the mother often whispered loving words to all her babies. The summer days were so bright and pleasant that the acorn never thought of anything but sunshine and an occasional shower to wash the dust off the leaves. But you know that summer ends and the autumn day come. Green cup of the acorn turned to a brown cup, and it was well that it grew stiffer and harder, for the cold winds began to blow. The leaves turned from green to golden brown, and some of them were whisked away by the rough wind. The little acorn began to grow uneasy. "Isn't life all summer?" it said. "No," whispered the mother oak. "The cold days come, and the leaf must go, and the acorns too. I must soon lose my babies." "Oh, I could never leave this kind bough," said the frightened acorn. "I could be lost and forgotten if I were to fall." So it tried to cling on all the closer to the bough. But at last it was alone there. The leaves were blown away, and some of them had made a blanket for the brown acorns laying on the ground. One night the tree whispered this message to the lonely acorn. "This tree is only your home for a time. This is not your true life. Your brown shell is only the cover for a living plant which can never be set free until the hard shell drops away. And that can never happen. And that can never happen until you are buried in the ground and wait for the spring to call you into life. So let go, little acorn, and fall to the ground, and some day you will wake to a new glorious life." The acorn listened and believed, for was not the tree its sheltering mother? So it bade her farewell, and loosening its hold, dropped to the ground. Then indeed it seemed as if the acorn was lost. That night a high wind blew and covered it deep under a heap of oak leaves. The next day a cold rain washed the leaves closer together, and trickling streams from the hillside swept some earth over them. The acorn was buried. "But I shall wake again," it said, and so it fell asleep. It might have been cold, but the frost fairies wove a soft white snow blanket to cover it, and so it kept warm. If you had walked through the woods that winter, you would have said the acorn was gone. But then you could not have seen the life slumbering within the brown cover. But spring came and called to all the sleeping things on the ground to waken and come forth. The acorn heard and tried to move, but the brown shell held it fast. Some raindrops trickled through the ground to moisten the shell, and one day the pushing life within was set free. The brown shell was of no more use, and it was lost in the ground. But the young plant was to live. Had heard voices calling it upward. It must arise. A new and glorious life, the mother oak had said. "I must arise," the acorn said, and up the living plant came. Up to the world of sunshine and beauty, it looked around. There was the same green moss in the woods, the same singing brook. "And I shall live and grow," it said. "Yes," called the mother oak. "You are now an oak tree. This is your real life." And the tiny oak tree was glad and tried to stretch higher towards the sun. End of section 14.